under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The New Jersey Open Public Meetings Law was enacted to ensure the right of the public to have advance notice of and to attend the meetings of the public body at which any business affecting their interests is discussed or acted upon. In accordance with this provision, with the provision of this act, the Pagoda Board of Education has caused notice of this meeting to be published by having the date, time, place thereof posted in the Pagoda Borough Hall, communicated by record, by letter to the record, filed with the clerk of the Borough of Pagoda, and posted on the Pagoda Board of Education website. Irfan.
Mr. Salicaldi?
Here.
Mrs. Olivares?
Present.
Mr. Olivares?
Present.
Mr. Chavez?
Present.
Mrs. Cruz?
Present.
Mr. Navarro?
Present.
Mrs. Oliva?
Present.
Ms. Reckitt?
Present.
Mr. Miranda?
Present.
We have the quorum.
Also present is Board Attorney Thomas Coben, School Business Administrator and Secretary Irfan Efsil, Assistant Board Secretary Elizabeth Ruiz, who we all love, and we have no student representative tonight. I'd like to open the floor on citizens on agenda items only. Do I have a motion to move?
Motion.
Mr. Chavez, do I have a second?
Alvarez.
Mr. Alvarez, any board discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Member, please state your name. You have 5 minutes to address agenda items only. Are we open online? Any hands up? All right. Who do we have? Susan Harper, you have the floor.
Thank you very much. I happen to notice on the agenda that there is a club that you changed the name to a business club. I was wondering if, in thinking about that, if the board and the school is planning to introduce business courses into the curriculum. To my understanding, we only have financial literacy in the curriculum, and I think that would be something that would enhance the curriculum for the students. Thank you very much.
So it used to be the DECA club, but because we do not have a business teacher, it did have to be changed to the business club. So that is for the change. And obviously we're always looking at any courses that would help our students. So for next year, we do not have any business courses, but something we're always looking at.
Thank you, Mrs. Harper. Anyone else?
No one else? Do you have a
motion to close? Motion. Mr. Chavez, second for Mrs. Ruckett. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? All right. Moving on to section 2-2. I'm sorry, 2-3. Wait.
The numbering.
Okay. Yes. Moving to 2-3, opening the floor for hearing of citizens on the superintendent's renewal of contract. Do I have a motion to move?
Olivo.
Mrs. Olivo, do I have a second?
Alcalde.
Mrs. Alcalde, any board discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any member who would like to address the superintendent's contract? You have the floor. Do we have anyone?
Yes, Julie.
Hi, Carpenter.
Hi, Mrs. Carpenter.
It's beneath. Big mouth. Okay, Connie Carpenter. I had the honor of sitting upstairs to listen to the budget and all the things that was done this last year. It was an amazing job on everybody's side, but starting, of course, with your leader, who is our superintendent. So I wholeheartedly support the renewal of Mr. Damian Kennedy.
Thank you, Mrs. Carpenter. Is that you, Mr. Nunez?
Evening. I just want to get my 2 cents in on this particular topic, which I think is a really, really important topic. Mr. Kennedy, I think that what you have done in this district and the lives that you have touched, the families that you have made a difference for through the education of their children, in my personal opinion, I don't think there's not enough money in the world to compensate for that effort. And I think you guys are just doing a fabulous, fabulous job. My family and I have been in town now for 23 years, and I think it's never been this good. You know, you guys are running the academics, the business, the physical aspect of our schools in an amazingly unprecedented way. And congratulations. And I think that you deserve all the wonderful things that come your way. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nunez. That's only 50% of the aspirations, right? Anyone else?
Hi, everybody. Sherry Solomon of 350 Larch. Do we still do that? Do we do the address? Not so much. Okay.
I mean, you
sold meeting. I just wanted to thank everybody for the stellar job you've been doing throughout the years. Your time and dedication does not go unappreciated. The staff in the school, I've never seen them happier. It's a pleasure to be on the PTO and just have nothing. I mean, Mr. Kennedy has been so available. I never thought I'd move into a town where the superintendent actually answers a phone call or is available for conversations and just comes from a place of yes and wanting to better the schools. I don't think the schools have ever been as amazing as they are right now. And that's thanks to this entire board and the superintendent. So I wanted to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You've done such an incredible job and it has been a pleasure sitting on the PTO because of you guys. So I appreciate you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Sherry. I've been poking at her all day. So thank you for your last words, Sherry. Anyone else? I have a motion to close.
Motion.
Mr. Chavez, do I have a second? Second. Mrs. Ruckett, any board discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? I assume that's congratulations to Mr. Kennedy. Move. Oh, okay. That's true. Well, at least from the public. Moving on to 3.1 section of the agenda, superintendent's report, which we're going to move towards the end of the meeting. Just to gather what we have going on to, this evening. Just make sure. Moving to 4.3 on the resolution, which is the approval for May 14th open work action meeting minutes and May 21st open regular meeting minutes. Do I have a motion to move 4.3?
Olivo.
Mrs. Olivo, do I have a second?
Second.
Mrs. Alvarez, any board discussion? Irfan.
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes to 4.1, and I abstained from 4.2 because I wasn't present and I haven't reviewed them.
Thank you. Mrs. Alvarez?
Yes.
Mr. Alvarez?
Yes.
Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Ruckett?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on to 6.25, education section. Which is approval for the items 6.1 through 6.24. Do I have a resolution to move 6.25?
Motion, Navarro.
Mr. Navarro, do I have a second?
Second.
Mrs. Ruckett, any board discussion? Irfan.
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes.
Mrs. Alvarez?
Yes.
Mr. Alvarez?
Yes.
Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Ruckett?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on to resolution 729, personnel section, which is approval of agenda items 7.1 through 7.28. Is there a motion to move 7.29?
Motion.
Mr. Chavez, do I have a second?
Second, Navarro.
Mr. Navarro, any board discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
We should have one more.
Oh, that's right. Roll call, Irfan.
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes, and I abstained from 7.16, 7.18, and 7.2.
16, 18?
From those.
16, 18?
7.2. 7.16, 7.18 and 7.2.
Correct. Two.
Yes, I recuse from those.
Thank you. Mrs. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Olivares?
I have to recuse myself from 7.1 and 7.2 and 7.21.
21.
But otherwise, for the rest of them, yes.
Yes, of course. Thank you. Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Reckitt?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on to 843 resolution in the finance section, which is approval of agenda items 81 through 842. Do we have a motion to move 843?
Motion.
Mrs. Cruz, do I have a second?
Second.
Olivo. Mrs. Alvarez, any board discussion? Irfan?
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Ruckett?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on, 9.6, buildings and grounds, which is approval of items 9.1 through 9.5. Do I have a motion to move 9.6?
Motion, Navarro.
Mr. Alvarez, second. Navarro, is there a board discussion? Roll call, Irfan.
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Reckitt?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on to 10.1, which is the addendum section for approval of a mathematics teacher. Do I have a motion to move 10.1?
Motion.
Chavez? Second?
Alcalde.
Alcalde, any discussion? Roll call, Irfan.
Mrs. Alcalde?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Olivares?
Yes.
Mr. Chavez?
Yes.
Mrs. Cruz?
Yes.
Mr. Navarro?
Yes.
Mrs. Olivo?
Yes.
Mrs. Reckitt?
Yes.
Mr. Miranda?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Moving on to the committee reports. Do we have any committee reports this evening? I believe we'll conclude those this later on. Old business. Do we have any old business? And we're moving on to new business where we will start our ceremony.
Yes. So first, I just have to, for the record, say we did have one HIB at Steen that was unfounded. That's part of the process and the policy. But I first, before I continue, I really want to thank everyone for their support. This is a team effort. I will always say that. It starts with my central office staff, Irfan, and all our secretaries. They do a tremendous job of supporting us. I have a great administration team. I'm losing one of them tonight. But that's what happens, I think, when we do great things. People steal our people. So, and then to the teachers and to the staff, and obviously with the support of the board. I've said this before, and I will continue saying this, when we are all rowing in the same direction, great things happen. And we have been rowing in the same direction. And I am honored. I've been here 15 years. I started in the high school. I am honored to lead this district, and I will continue to try to do my best job every day for our students, our community, and our staff. So thank you for that. We had an incredible year. The last 2 weeks of celebrations, honoring our students with award ceremonies and graduations. Highlights included our inaugural 18 to 21 graduation ceremony, all the way down to our joyful pre-K disabled ceremonies. The grand finale was Friday night at the high school graduation, and a huge congratulations to all the school staff and students for their outstanding efforts. If you haven't seen it, there is a beautiful picture of a rainbow over the high school that happened after the graduation. It's starting to make its way around social media, shocker, but it was a great picture, and it kind of summed up the year it was for me. It rained a little bit, but then a beautiful rainbow appeared and we had a great ceremony. This year's graduating class has been accepted to over 110 different colleges, university and trade schools, and has accumulated over $9.3 million in scholarships and grants. This year, four students went above and beyond their high school curriculum and achieved their associate's degree from Bergen Community College while still in high school. So when I please call your name, I know I have a couple of students that emailed me that had work or had something else that they had to go to tonight, but is David Castillo here?
No. No, he couldn't make it, remember?
David Castillo cannot make it. I know Michaela Douglas emailed me. Mm-hmm. Is Joshua Guessamundo here?
No, he's... No.
and Annabelle Jimenez, Laura, they both, a bunch of them had some things that they couldn't make tonight, but I did want to at least acknowledge them. Next, we are excited to recognize our staff members of the year. These outstanding educators were nominated and selected by a committee at each school. Their dedication to our students in Bogota is unwavering, and they strive every day to help our students. First in the high school, Diane Baranello.
And what happened to Sandra? Good, the other side.
In the middle school, Lauren Tomlinson.
No.
Got a good picture. At Bixby School, Melissa Dusher. And finally, at Steen School, Maria Castillo.
I'm going to miss Sherry.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Huh? Time is at a loss. Oh.
Next up, our retirees. This one came in at the last minute. He is moving out west. He's been our social studies department chair. He's been teaching in Bogota for 24 years. I worked very close with him as a high school VP and principal. Always very positive, always very logical. Mr. Thomas Hughes. And our next retiree served 27 years in Bogota, and I believe upwards of 40 years in education. 39 and a half. He couldn't get through the rest of that half a year. He had to go in December. He was a physical education teacher, physical education chair, athletic director, and also a volleyball, softball coach, wrestling mentor. He's been a staple in the community with anything athletics. We are happy to announce that he was approved tonight to continue coaching volleyball. And if you look up there, there's a good reason why we're keeping him around. Last year was arguably his worst year as a volleyball coach here. And I would say 99% of the coaches in New Jersey would sign up for that year that he just had. Mr. Brad DiRupo.
I'll get it for you. Thank you very much.
So this next award is for a educator who has been here for 9 years. I think everyone is aware of where he's going. He's been a very good man. He's been a good friend, and he works hard. He runs a good building. He's always there to help anyone that needs it. He's going to be missed. I have this thing that I say to my, I've said to him, and he gets upset when I say this, but I say, as administrators, we're replaceable, right? Like, the show will go on the next day. And he always got upset with me that I would say that. He was offended that I said that to him. But I said that, and in jest a little bit, but I think it's going to be, I'm going to see firsthand if everyone is replaceable. And it might be somewhere I come up and say, well, maybe you were a little right. But we're going to miss him. I'm fortunate that he's becoming the superintendent in Fairview, and he's part of the superintendent's group that I'm in. We're already talking about meeting in the summer to go over things and work together as we've worked together for the last 9 years. Mr. Damon Inglese.
Can we?
Come on, lady.
Okay.
Just victory patterns, everyone.
I wanted to say some quick words.
Right.
Oh, you're going. Go ahead.
So 9 years ago, I came to Pagoda, and it's difficult coming from the outside in as a principal, but the community made me feel so welcome, the administration, the board, and, you know, we've had a great run for 9 years. I can't thank the Board of Education enough that sits here, that supported me in these past few years. You guys believe in my vision and what I've done. And Damian, you know, I can't ask for a better friend. And what we've been through, him and I have been here the longest. And we've seen a lot of ups and downs, but we were steady together. And that really hit me when I went to the county and I had a meeting as a new superintendent. And, you know, they normally recommend you to team up with another superintendent or a district that they think is running really well and that should be watched. And before, when I was in the back, Trina had said to me, she said, if you ever need something or swing by, well, that's exactly what the county said to me. They said, we can't think of a better district to team you up with than Pagoda, because since Damian's been superintendent, the place has really taken off. And they praised him and his leadership, and they praised Mr. Chang at the meeting. And, you know, I texted him when I left, and I said, I'm glad to have been a part of this, and I'm glad to have been a part of this board and what we've accomplished during my 9 years and during his 6 years as superintendent. I thank you all. I will miss you tremendously.
We are so lucky to have you.
So today is going to be bittersweet because Damon is leaving us, and he ran a very unique operation at Bixby. It didn't matter where you came from. He treated everyone equally. very unique style of consistency. He's one of a kind. I got to spend some time with him in under his operation and just watch what he does and what he did. And everything is meticulous. Everything is prepared. It's well thought out. I'm learning more and more that he practices graduation walking 4 or 5 times, sometimes 8. He's a perfectionist. There are several things in life that I've learned. If you want things to look good, then you have to become a perfectionist. If you want the people to grow in your district and in your areas, then you have to love everyone. And most importantly, you have to make sure that everyone's happy when they're around you. And that's what he excels at. There's not an educator I've ever heard that doesn't say that they're happy. He always has a mob of teachers and educators and supervisors around him. There's a reason for that, because if people didn't like you, they would not hinge next to you. And he's just exceptional. And anything you moved around in his office and you turn nine, you turn back, he replaced it. He put it right back where he had it. His record keeping is exceptional. And just respect to the public officials in town, to this board. He's unique. When you show up to the graduation, whether you went or whether you attended or not, your name was placed on a seat. And sometimes people don't understand what we go through, and we're running late because we're juggling our families, our careers, and our jobs, and we want to get to their graduation. And you get there, and your name is just reserved, and everyone, any board member's name. And I truly thank you for that respect, because that's one thing you walk with. You walk with respect. Thank you. This is a hard one for me. I'm not a crier, but you know, I've been telling my wife who's sitting over there that you know, you come to a town and you get involved because you care about all the right reasons, and you find all the wrong reasons why you probably shouldn't get involved. But there's always this energy and they're in a diamond in the rough. So I'm going to give a speech, and then I'm going to let Kelly say something. And I think Kylie as well wants to say something. And then we're going to go on to awarding this individual, give him a placard. And then we're going to show a real brief video. So as I said, today's a bittersweet, but surely one for me. I have to wish a very close friend a farewell from our beautiful town of Bogota, and at the same time wish her the best on her move and her future. Why we celebrate Sherry tonight? Because moving forward, we have to celebrate and show gratitude to those who give heartlessly to our community. Often residents don't understand what it takes behind the scenes to make all these great things happen. They forget we have family too, that we also have obligations, and that the delicate balance of not forgetting your family is the hardest part of all that we do. So while we are up here with this grand stage and these microphones and these videos and the Zooms, I want to thank every single PTO member, every single volunteer, our staff, and our superintendent, who, by the way, never gets home to his own children who thrive, but he watches ours. I often tell Mr. Kennedy, don't forget to go see your son and your daughter. And today's contract renewal is our gratitude to Mr. Kennedy. We have to start showing gratitude amongst our community, because then we won't thrive. Thank you from the bottom of my heart to all those volunteers. I will never forget the moment I met Sherry. I was campaigning down Larch Avenue. There's no secret behind that. On my very first election. And I ran into large hair, little person, bigger than life smile. I mean, she had a lot of hair. On her right side, she had this really chunky baby who was Jax. And she was actually wearing socks, no slippers, no sneakers. And she was running behind baby Joey at the time. I can only recall she complained about a few things, and I mean few lightly. And I responded, the only things that would change is when people get involved. Surely enough, Sherry became involved. Called me about a few hours later and discussed all the changes and ideas she had. She often complained that we were stuck in our old mindset. And anyone who knows me knows I adapted really quick because that's my belief. I would only reply that we needed to spark some energy and some grit under our people in Bogota. And if we did so, people would get involved. Just like that, Sherry was born. Her ideas, her energy, her push to be the best we can be meant everything to me and everything to our friends who currently sit on this board. She got involved in the political conversation to bring upon good things, ideas that worked for all, and had a voice to make sure that everyone benefit. That's all she ever spoke. Let's stop the clicks and let it work for everyone. I often argued with her about the gray tape that existed in the political system in some of the areas. Sherry would respond as she did last night. Frank, if anyone can do it, you can. Do what Frank knows best and get to the finish line. I tasked Sherry with helping me improve Bogota Day, which we then changed the name to the Fall Festival. We killed it, Sherry. Food vendors, bounce houses, BBQs, petting zoos, hay rides, and so much more. She had met her match, she said. I wanted Sherry and Eric to feel at home. The Solomov was the first Jewish family I had known who lived in Bogota. That was probably my ignorance, but that's who I knew. You know, I'm doing this without trying to cry. The menorah was born. The menorah lighting was also born, and she invited everyone in the entire community from all walks of life, religions, backgrounds. It didn't matter to Sherry. The Solomovs breed inclusion, and they never separated from our community because of their beliefs and religion. We spent hours discussing our similarities of how I was a Christian and learning how a lot about the Jewish culture. They invited everyone into their homes with no regard, always willing and lend a helping hand, and the helping hands was born. There was ups and downs, differences, and external behaviors that at times challenged her faith in Bogota, but she paid forward and continued to do more. She was proud to see us come together and become as united as possible. Sherry, you are the true meaning of a vibration that breaks the plates below the earth, and then they start creating new ones. That new one today allows more of our Bogota residents to have become friends, common neighbors, and volunteer at events. Today was an extraordinary example of our unity, with over 84 volunteers looking to help. It doesn't matter where you come from or what we have, but we share the same love for the kids. And as long as you stand true to that, it becomes priceless. As seen briefly on the video we'll see today, most of you have probably forgotten because of our busy lives, but Stand for Something was born with Sherry as well, where she met many volunteers in Bogota and residents, and she sort of forced them to stand for something. Because if anyone knows Sherry's force, she makes you do the job. She brought monetary value to help others in need, to help all three PTOs and more. COVID hit us. There was a lot of fear, scary moments for our kids and our residents, and we didn't know what to do, but Sherry did. Sherry put on masks. She helped us give out hands with masks on, and even in her wild dream, she decided to run for office. Well, not successful, it didn't matter. She wanted to make a point that we needed to vibrate our community. During COVID, she gathered all her friends and she donated to Holy Name. She started a blood drive. She just did all these things that sometimes we will never think of. She thought out the box. So with all that said, Sherry, you changed the game and you elevated the expectations of our community. I'm so grateful for the time you spent in Bogota. And I know you hate we are doing this right now, because you often tell me that your Torah doesn't expect anything in return for your good deeds. And how you appreciate someone. You appreciate someone because you take their values and their religions and you respect them and you voice them. And while I know this is an educational setting, I pushed the line to let you know that we understood you and that we love you. Sherry and Eric, I wish you the best. And I want you to know that I love you guys. You have a friend in me. And I've learned that in childhood. To your kids who you weren't bringing tonight, I often tell you they see crazy mommy and daddy, busy mommy and daddy, but they needed to hear these words from the podium. Jordan, Joey, Jax, you will forever be Bogosians. And I love you kids. Play the video.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down a road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a pal and a confidant. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off. Won't you stand up and take a bow? And if you threw a party, invited everyone you knew, well, you would see the biggest gift would be for me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. 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 If it's a car you lack, I'd surely buy you a Cadillac. Whatever you need, any time of the day or night. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off, won't you stand up and take a bow?
Thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for pushing me harder to be the best that we can be in Bogota. I truly appreciate all you've done for our community, all you've done for your friends, and for your family. Thank you so much. I wish you the best. Good luck, Florida. You have one of the toughest, smallest, relentless people I've ever met. Good luck. I love you, Sherry. I love you, Eric. And I love you to the Solomon family.
Madam President, thank you so much for everything. Your hard work, your dedication, your love. We love you so much. We're gonna miss you so much. Good luck for the future. And thank you so much for everything you've done for our school and our town. We love you from the bottom of our hearts. Take care. We'll see you soon.
Sherry, I want to say thank you, to Eric, to the whole family. It is incredible to know that you're leaving, but you left Bogota a little better. Bogota is better because of everything you did for Bogota. For our kids, for the people in Bogota, for everyone.
Sherry Solomon, how am I ever going to thank you enough? When we met you, what, over 8 years ago in front of your house with Frank? I know you were not long for Bogota. Because you had so much to give then, you have so much energy. And I just want to thank you on behalf of myself, little Johnny Mitchell, the Irish guy in the hill. Thank you for giving life back to Bogota. You know, we all have our differences, but you were there every day and you gave so much. And we were lucky to have you. And the kids were lucky to have you. You gave so much esteem, so much to the rec department, and so much to everyone. Even though we all don't think the same or believe in the same thing. You were there for the kids. And you were there for your family. You're right. You put Eric on the back burner. And you're going to do what's right for your family now. And I wish you nothing but the best, happiness and love and peace. And we'll never forget. I'll never forget. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you. Sincerely, Johnny. Take care.
All right. You can come up, Kylie. Come on up.
I'm going to try to do this really hard without crying. All right. Good evening, everyone. We are gathered here today to thank Sherry and Eric, who I lovingly call my big bro and my big sis. I'm not going to talk about how they influenced my life because I could go on forever, but I'm going to talk about how they influenced Bogota as a community. Once in a while, in the middle of ordinary life, extraordinary people will come into your life, show you that they're still good in humanity. And being able to bring people together in such a positive way, such as during COVID, when we sent snacks and made donations for the nurses and doctors at Holy Name Hospital, or doing a stands for something, the lemonade stand, to get donations for different programs at the schools in Bogota. Or getting people together to do a car parade for someone's birthday who is going through medical challenges at the time. Even building a cafe in town to give back to the community. These are only a few of the wonderful and exceptional deeds that were done to elevate Bogota even more. There are way too many to mention. I know if any one of you had an idea of something that would enhance the lives or the children in Bogota, and you brought it to Shari, she would say to you, I'll see how I can make it happen. I can't speak for everyone here, but I know in my heart that they made Bogota a better place. And I will miss them terribly. Love you both always, your little sis.
Mrs. DiCongelio.
Don't worry, I will not make you cry. Before I started at Steen, I already knew the legend that is Sherry Solomov. And to put it mildly, I was a little concerned. While most will call my personality reserved, Sherry is anything but that. She is the PTO president who's one part Mary Poppins, one part Energizer Bunny, and one part, what the heck is she gonna do now? Sherry, your dedication is truly unmatched. Need someone to volunteer at 5 a.m.? She'd be there, and she'd be there with a smile somehow, while also being super mom and a business owner of 3 or 4 different companies. This is because she does not do anything half. She is always all out. To put it simply, you are a force of nature in all the best ways. And most notably, this happy tornado has also become a very good friend of mine. She has brought all of the best elementary parts out of my more reserved high school me. She reminds me to sing off key, dance, and laugh. She is the person you can call for anything and everything. And side note, I can confirm people call you for everything and anything often. And I can confidently say she brightens up my day every day because I can also confirm she is in my office every single day. So here's to Sherry, the ever crazy, fun, dedicated, and as she would say about every event, the absolute best PTO president I could ever ask for. You are wonderfully chaotic and wholeheartedly committed to making this school and this town the best it could be. My only regret is that I did not get to meet you sooner, and I can only hope Boca knows how lucky they are to have you. To my favorite chooch, you'll be missed.
Jerry, come on up.
This gift is recognition of your selfless service and unwavering support as the students of Pomona Public Schools. We extend our heartfelt gratitude, and for this, we often say thank you.
And as a true Virgo, she says she feels awkward. That's a Virgo. Do you want me to? Oh, yep. We have to open up hearing of the citizens for the public. Do you have a motion?
Olivo.
Mrs. Ruckett for a second. Any board discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Any member want to state your name? You have 5 minutes.
Sabrina Kearns, good evening. On behalf of the Bixby PTO, we would like to take a moment to recognize Damon and the impact that he had on the Bixby school community. For the last 3 years, as PTO president, I had the privilege of getting an inside view of how Bixby operates and how Damon works as a leader. When I became president, I joined an online community for fellow PTO presidents. And one of the common complaints was that it was really hard to get the administrators on board with what the members of the organization wanted to do in collaboration. And I can tell you that my experience was the exact opposite. Damon accepted my phone calls, texts, and wild ideas at all hours of the nights, day, night, and weekends. He was open to the mission of our PTO, which is to enhance the students' experience by supplementing enriching activities and bringing families together. As a teacher myself, I have worked with administrators over the years. Damon has set the bar high. Whether they realize it or not, principals shape the culture of a school, and under Damon's leadership, Bixby Elementary has thrived. Damon, your professionalism and strong leadership and high expectations have left a lasting impression on the staff, the students, and parents alike, and I am proud to also call you friend.
Your influence will be felt long after you've moved on to your next role. While we're sad to see you leave, we're also incredibly proud of your accomplishment and excited for what lies ahead. You will always hold a special place in the Bixby Bulldog family, and your legacy will continue to impact our school community. So on behalf of the parents, students, and everyone at Bixby Elementary School, we just want to extend our heartfelt thanks and best wishes on your future endeavors. And please just accept this as a little token of our appreciation for your new office.
Susan Harper.
Thank you so much. It's been very impressive just hearing everybody today. There's so many people who are game changers in people's lives. I thought I had my hand up for you, Mr. Kennedy, when they asked for comments. And I do want to just take a moment to recognize your leadership and your accessibility. As everybody knows, I'm a person who just raises a few comments here or there every once in a while, but you are always responsive. And I think for that, you know, on behalf of all the parents, we appreciate that. I also want to commend the teachers and the administrators honored today and their lifelong professional commitment to our students and all that they have done to help them excel. I also want to commend the high school PTO leaders, Kristen Meberg, and the amazing leadership and the many high school parents who are in the room for their PTO efforts. And I appreciate all that they do to keep us informed and our kids motivated to be involved. And the tribute to Eric and the work of the incomparable Sherry Said Solomov, excuse me. Her contributions and positivity to the school and the community, lifting us all up to be better, have been enormous and indelible. And for that, I think we are all grateful to you, Sherry, and to Eric, and we will all definitely miss you. I know that we have a lot of other things that are gonna be happening this summer. I was hoping to get an update on just what's happening in terms of the timeline out in the fields, if you have a chance. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mrs. Harper. Okay, nothing happened. So, go ahead. Come on. Go ahead.
Sorry, every meeting's a little different, so I don't know what the protocol is. I'm Sarah Cazaro. If you don't know me yet, I'm sure most of you do. I'm the library director at the Bogota Public Library. I chose a really great meeting to come to because it's really nice to see how well everybody's doing, and congratulations to everyone. I just wanted to get the conversation started. So we launched a new strategic plan in January. I know I'm not really good with the mic right now. I'm only good at karaoke, so it's like a whole... So basically we launched a new strategic plan in January, and I did meet with the media specialists this past winter, but I wanted to get the conversation going with the rest of the administration. We have goals where we want to further improve the communication between the schools and the public library. I want to make sure that we're having resources and programming that go best with the curriculum and that support our students outside of school. As you know, our youth services coordinator, Tommy Skronich, does the bulk of the outreach to the schools, and he does a great job. And I know he's happy to continue that, but I'd like you to get to know me as well. And I'd like to make sure that we're providing what the students need when school is closed, when school is out. What else was I going to say here? So basically, I just wanted to reach out. I will be reaching out to principals and admin and teachers as well. To see how we can better support everybody. As we close the school year, I'd like us to get started thinking about the new year and how, the library can support everyone. Also, I just wanted to shout out Marco Navarro. He is a wonderful liaison to our library board. I've learned a lot from him already, and I'm excited for more meetings with him. I don't know if he feels the same, but that's okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah.
And just so everyone knows, there's some food and cookies and snacks and coffee. That's for everyone. Please make use of it. They've been working since 6 a.m. So just make sure, take it home at least. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Ian Englehart, and I'm captain of the cheer team. I am here with my co-captain,
Elizabeth Friedman.
And we have a statement and a question. Today, we would like to discuss the termination of our cheer coach, Kiara Mateo. Our cheer team has improved so much this year.
Guys, I do have to interrupt you on this. If this is a personnel matter, the board can't consider it or hear your comments on this. Okay, you need to submit these in writing to the superintendent because the board can't hear this stuff in public. It shouldn't be spoken about in public. I would ask you, if you have it written down, submit it to the superintendent for consideration by the board in executive session. That's the way this has to work.
All right. Thank you. Okay. We will be doing that.
All right. Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you. Anyone else? Come on up, Mr. Nunez.
Jerry, nothing else needs to be said. I've done enough crying tonight. You know, you really set the standard, right? And our community, you know, has a choice. Do we move in that direction? Do we continue to move in that direction? Or do we do other stuff, right? And I kind of feel like we live in an amazing, amazing community. And that community became a lot more amazing when you became a part of it. And your legacy is going to allow us to be even better, right? So enough of that. Lots of good stuff that we're hearing about tonight. Wonderful things, great accomplishments. Damon, again, you know, it just unbelievable. You know, what you did at Bixby, what you did in the district, you know, not going to get into specifics, but the class that you have as a human being is through the roof. And I think that many people that are here clearly know that. So, you know, good luck and lots of blessings to you and your family as you move on to your next journey. The last thing that I want to say, and I want to keep on with the positivity that we're all experiencing here tonight, I want to just express my gratitude to the board members. It is abundantly clear to me, and I would hope to our community, your level of dedication to the children, to the families, to our community at large. You know, I'm like amazed. You guys show up everywhere. You are there for the families of Bogota. Frank, I think that you are certifiably insane. I mean, you put yourself there, you know, and you create this fun environment. You know, I see stuff that you've done at the schools and with the children. And it takes a really special human being to lend themselves to that. And I personally think that you have provided an amazing level of leadership, not only to the board, but to this community. And I think your fellow board members would also vote in favor of that because, you know, you guys are in lockstep. You're in lockstep with the administration. You guys are making things happen. You are bringing your A game every single day. I know that you guys show up everywhere. You know, I see it on social media. I talk to you guys. I know that you're everywhere. And if any one of you is not down for that, then go do something else. Go do something else, right? You know, as a board member, there's a graduation, there's a school event. I can't think of anything more important, barring, you know, any situation that happens. You guys show up. If for whatever reason, as a board member, you don't think it's important to show up to a graduation or to a school event, this is not really for you. I thank you. As a resident, as a parent of children that went to Bogota school, I thank you for your commitment, for your dedication, and for making a difference. What you guys are doing is monumental. You literally, and again, under the leadership of our superintendent and the support of our amazing teachers. Last thing I'm going to say is I've believed for some time that our society gets it wrong. Our society, you know, pays exorbitant amount of money to athletes and to actors. And the people that make the real difference, you know, the people that instill the values that allows people to be the best that they can be in anything and everything, including sports and acting and all kinds of things, are teachers. And teachers always have to fight like for raises and for things and for all kinds of things, you know? I know personally, I wouldn't have wanted to spend 12 years of my children's education hanging out with them 5 days a week. And I'm their parent. Teachers are just amazing. And at the end of the day, it is all about the teachers because they make it all about our children and our community. So thank you guys.
Hi.
Just state your name.
My name is Tanya Feliz Patron. I am so happy to see that I know a lot of your faces. I know I haven't been around actively in the community as much as I want to, but everybody has their baggage, you know? But I do want to thank Mr. DeRupo for being an excellent coach for my Tana. I do want to thank Mr. Ingles for being an excellent principal at Bixby. It was her first year at fourth grade, and Tana really appreciated you just painting the walls your first year. I do want to thank Ms. Hughes for teaching my Ari beautiful songs and lyrics and acting. And thank you for bringing me back. I help out Ms. Hughes now, I did last year, with the play props. And it was a great opportunity. And I wish you the best of luck over there. And was it Cali? I don't know if it's a secret. It's truly a beautiful thing to see a community come together. So I'm grateful for following Mr. Nunez because he was talking about being grateful. And he's one of the first people that I met in this small little tiny little town. So thank you so much. But I do want to publicly say thank you to Eric for looking at me as a maker. We talk about engines and making and creating and woodworking, and he's like, kick ass, sorry. I want to say thank you to Jax and Joey and Jordan for always seeing me going, oh man, Miss Tanya. So sweet. But most of all, Sherry, you allowed me to come out of my shell. You helped me start a small business. You gave me encouragement. You cried with me. Stop. When, as a mother, I needed support. And it's so beautiful that I can walk around my town and I do see my husband and I sometimes walk around together and I see faces that I recognize. And to know that I can come to a safe place that you've provided for the community where students can come and work and just enjoy, I thank you. I really do from the bottom of my heart. It's been 5 years since my girls have been in the school system. And I have to say, being in these walls right now, even the gym is an improvement. So bravo to you guys. I am a teacher as well. And today I got a thank you card from a student. And really, truly, it takes a village. And I hope that everybody continues to give, everybody continues to grow and develop. Because when I first got here, I felt like the town was so divided. And little by little, it seems like it's being unified. So I want to say thank you to all of you for your hard work. We're going to miss you. I love you too.
Anyone else? May I have a motion to close? Did anyone else? I saw her. No. Okay. Do I have a motion to close?
Motion.
I just want to say something really quick.
You can say it right after. Let's just close it. All right. Motion to close?
Yes.
Second, Chavez, all in favor?
Aye.
You have the floor, Calvin.
I just want to say, Sherry, you're amazing. And the love that this town has shown you is very well deserved. I've been in Bogota only 3 years. I've had great neighbors, Frank, and you're a force too. The two of you together, like it's you know, it's something. But I also just want to recognize Ian, because, you know, for a student to come here, and I think this is the right thing to do. Unfortunately, we couldn't hear you because there's legal reasons. Mm-hmm. But the fact that you're coming here to voice your concerns as a student, I think that we need to encourage that. And I encourage you to continue to stay involved, Ian, because I've coached you as in the mock trial. You're an amazing student. You're going to be an amazing lawyer someday if that's the path you choose. And if it's not, it's okay. Whatever you choose, you're going to be amazing. I just want to say, I encourage you to continue doing this. I don't want you to be discouraged. There's legal reasons why we couldn't hear this, but the fact that you came out here prepared to do this is really amazing. And it's nothing less than I would expect from you. So I'm glad to that you came here to voice your concerns. That's all.
Oh, anyone else? So I have a motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Chavez and Alvarez, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Enjoy your food.